Molly Carmel here, your coach, your bestie. I'm your girl who's fiercely devoted to your freedom. Today's topic is travel. And I have a big travel coming up on Wednesday where I'm going to Santa Fe for a 5-day training. Staying in a hotel, eating with people at every single meal. I'm not really nervous about it because I've been doing this for over a decade, but a little bit of me, the old me, comes up and says, oh my God, how am I gonna do this? But I thought, what a perfect opportunity for us to talk about how we travel for work. Because we have a separate YouTube video on how we travel for vacation. I think it's like a kind of different thing, although there are very, very similar pieces that we can put together. So here's what I'm gonna do, right? First things first. I know it's a little bit annoying that I talk about the same things over and over and over again, but repetition is prayer. And when it comes to having a loving relationship with food, planning is key. It's key. It's the whole thing. I probably have 15,000 YouTube videos on it. Can't stop, won't stop, can't stop, won't stop. And the other thing is, like, listen, there's a high probability that I'm gonna have a plan and something else is gonna happen. But at least I'm like negotiating off of something that was made from the deepest wisdom and the most loving place. So take a minute and plan what you're going to be doing and don't get so stuck up in the rigidity of if it's gonna be a perfect plan, because guess what? It's not going to be. Like, nothing goes perfectly in life, guys, and that's why we need to like turn on our brains, have a plan, and also be flexible. So here's what I'm gonna do, right? Number one, I'm calling ahead. I'm asking what the hotel has available. I'm asking if there's a fridge in the room. I'm calling ahead to the conference. I'm seeing like what they're serving, because if they're not serving anything that's gonna be sugar flour free, which I feel certain it is, because as you well know, so many people are on their individual food journeys these days that a lot of times they have food that really works for people who don't eat sugar and flour. And if they don't, it's unlikely that I'm the first person that's gonna ask to be sugar free, flour free. Lots of people are asking to be gluten free. Lots of people are plant-based these days. So just remember, a lot of people are having requests and are having asks when it comes to going to conferences like I'm going to. So I'll call ahead. And the thing is, like, if there's a supermarket nearby and there's a refrigerator in my room, I might go pick up a few things. I might go pick up a little fruit. I might bring some Ezekiel bread with me in my bag. Like, this really depends on what's available to me. But here's what I'm always, always, always gonna do. For me, I'm always gonna pack some nuts for snack, and I'm always gonna pack my 5 favorite Primal Kitchen protein bars to bring with me in a pinch. Because the thing is, if breakfast isn't working, I can always have snack for breakfast. Like, so there's always ways that we can be negotiating. And like, when I'm there, this is the thing about planning and travel. What ends up happening is that we literally forget to turn on our brains. And you can always make something work. Now, it may not be like the most perfect meal you've ever had in your life. It may not be like your favorite meal that you have for dinner that's like weighed and measured, or like your favorite thing that you make. And that's gonna have to be okay. But what I'm gonna promise you is that when I'm traveling, there's not gonna be a day where I ever throw in the towel. This is always gonna be the skill I'm gonna beg of you. Turn on your brain. Do your best. Like, in all of this diet drama and trauma, we've forgotten about the idea of doing our very best. And the thing is I've gone to lots and lots of conferences in my life where I've just said, you know, screw it. I'm just gonna eat like everybody else. And so what I can promise you is, regardless of what they're serving at this conference, regardless of if my plan works perfectly or if my plan is like, I get there and I'm like, oh my God, I totally misread this whole situation. What I'm gonna promise you is this: there's not gonna be a minute where I'm not trying my hardest. And there's not gonna be a minute where I'm not taking care of myself, or I'm not maybe asking for what I need, or where we're sitting at a place like Thai food, one of the hardest places for someone who doesn't eat sugar and flour to eat, where I'm not gonna be asking questions, taking care of myself, just doing my best? Because when I think about it, it's like, A, this is a conference where I want to be present. There's a lot for me to learn at it, right? I want to meet people. I want to get the most out of it as I can. And there's no way that I can do that if I'm lapsing in sugar and flour, because that impacts like my biology. It starts my craving. Like it makes me stop feeling good about my, it gets so complicated and messy if I'm going to go that way. And like, I want to be fully present. So I have to take care of my relationship with food because I have to take care of my relationship with myself. And so even if it isn't perfect at this trip, I'm going to be leaving being like, yeah, I did my very best. This is the skill, my friends. Like, this is what nobody's talking about. It's so black and white. Like, I was good on my trip or I was bad on my trip. And let me tell you something, it's just like not how it goes. So what I'm gonna guarantee is I'm gonna go in with a really solid plan, asking questions, you know, bringing some stuff of my own. I don't know, even when I get there, if I find that I'm in real trouble, like I'll take an Uber to a supermarket and pick up stuff, you know, whatever it is. And if I didn't have the financial means to go get the Uber, then I would just make it work there and I would ask questions and I'd ask for help. It's like, I had a client once say this thing to me, like, Molly, if you were like locked on an airplane and the only thing on the airplane they had was cake, would you eat cake? And I thought about it and I was like, well, probably not. I'd probably just be hungry. And she was like, but what if you were on the airplane for 24 hours, you know, would you eat the cake? And I was like, yeah, I guess I would eat the cake, you know? And it's like, because I would eat the cake, it's like, I'd be starving. The point is like, if you can turn on your brain and you can be thoughtful the whole time that you're traveling, you're gonna be great. And listen, let's just say I lose my mind and I say, you know what? I'm going off the rails and I'm gonna have ice cream or something like that. Here's the thing, get right back on as soon as you possibly can, because that's the second most loving thing you can do. The first most loving thing you can do is plan, keep your eye on your goals, keep your eye on how you wanna be feeling about yourself and your relationship with food. But plan B is also, if that doesn't work, you get back on right as quickly as you can and you do a little recon about like what happened so that you're smarter for next time. This is a process. This is a relationship. And frankly, learning how to take your relationship on trips is a new skill. And so you may not do it perfectly, but you're gonna get better and better every time. So listen, I wanna hear about what you think about traveling for work. I wanna hear your questions, your comments, your thoughts. Like, let's get into a conversation about it. You deserve full freedom. And it starts here. And listen, all I wanna do is talk about this kind of stuff with you guys. I want to know everything going on with you and I want you to know everything going on with me. So here's what I need you to do. I need you to subscribe to this channel. I need you to turn on your notifications so that we are in it to win it. Get it done, leave comments, let me know what you want to be talking about and I'll talk to you soon.